Good morning, everybody, and welcome to our second week of online learning. This week, we're going to be talking about the forms of music. Today, we're talking about strophic forms. Strophic means there is one theme in the song. So when we diagram the form of the song, we'll get an A theme, and another A theme. So form, if you remember from last week, this is the definition of form according to the Britannica Encyclopedia. Musical form, the structure of a musical composition. The term is regularly used in two senses, to denote a standard type or genre and to denote the procedures in a specific work. The nomenclature for the various musical formal types may be determined by the medium of performance, the technique of composition, or by function. So this week, we're going to be using this in the second form of the definition. We're going to be finding the specific procedures in the work. So we're going to be breaking down how many themes are in a song. After that, we will be categorizing each piece based on what we learned. So we break down the form, find out how many themes there are, which is the second definition. And then we're going to apply it to a standard type of form by categorizing each piece. So before you can understand how to diagram songs, you need to understand what a phrase is. We've talked about phrases during band rehearsal a lot. We do things like don't breathe here because this is the middle of the phrase. Take out your pencil, write in this breath because this is the end of the phrase. So what we're talking about in band with a phrase is the same thing in vocal music with a phrase. Where do we breathe? Where's the punctuation? What makes sense? A phrase is a short section of music in a musical composition. It's typically 4 measures or 16 beats long, but sometimes there are shorter and longer phrases. In band music, many of the rehearsal marks are at the beginning and end of phrases. There are typically at least 2 phrases that make up a theme, and sometimes as many as 6 phrases will make up a theme. For example, in Semper Fidelis, which was the march I diagrammed for you last week, the first strain was made up of 2 phrases, and all of the strains really were made up of 2 phrases, with the exception of the trio, which had 3 phrases in it. So strophic form. In order to tell the form of a song, we have to identify how many themes are in the song. Themes can be made up of a single phrase, but more typically they're made up of 2 to 4 phrases. For example, in Mary Had a Little Lamb, there's 4 phrases, so I'm going to sing them for you. So the first phrase, Mary had a little lamb, that's the first phrase. Mary had a little lamb whose fleece was white as snow. That's the second phrase. The third phrase, and everywhere that that's the fourth phrase. Everywhere that Mary went, the lamb was sure to go. So we have 4 phrases in this example of Mary Had a Little Lamb. So when we look very closely at this song, we're going to realize that the first 2 phrases make up the A theme. We know that the first 2 phrases make up the A theme because they kind of have the feeling of the end. So if you play the guitar, you probably know a little bit about cadences. And here at the end of the second phrase, we cadence into a tonic chord, a root chord, and that is how we know that that's the end of the phrase. Or sorry, the end of the theme. Now, if we look closely at the third phrase, it is a different rhythm than the first phrase, but all of the notes are in the same order, so it's melodically the same. So, for example, in phrase 1, we have E, D, C, D, E, E, E. And in phrase 3, the notes are in the same order. E, D, C, D, E, E, E. So this is the same melodic content, so it's going to be another A theme. So this song, Mary Had a Little Lamb, the form would be A, A, because we have an A theme from measures 1 through 8, and we have an A theme from measures 9 through 16. Another example of a strophic song is Amazing Grace. So going through the phrases, we have the first phrase. Amazing grace, how sweet the sound. And then the second phrase. That saved a wretch like me. The third phrase. I once was lost, but now am found. And the fourth phrase. Was blind, but now I see. So, all four of those phrases are going to make up the A theme in this song. I feel like in this particular song, we know that all four phrases make up the A theme because the melodic line is pretty similar. Everything is starting low and going higher and then coming back down in each phrase. So we're not hearing a lot of differences in rhythm, and the melodic intervals are all pretty much the same. The first phrase and the second phrase are almost identical, and the final phrase starts off the same as well. So the only phrase that's a question mark is probably the third phrase. But like I said, it has a skip at the beginning, and it's going up and then down. So I think that you could say that the melodic material is the same, which is why we're calling it all the A theme. So once again, diagramming form is identifying how many different themes exist and in what order they're presented. So strophic form is also called one-part song form. The word strophic comes from the Greek word strophe, literally meaning verse. So the term one part derives from the repetition of one distinct musical theme as the song progresses. So in Amazing Grace, you can see that our music, the actual notes, are going to stay exactly the same, but we have five different verses of words. So each time we hear the music start over, or on each repeat of a verse, we would add another letter A. So for Amazing Grace, we have five A's because we have five verses. So here you can see all my verses. We have A, 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 and A. Another example of a strophic song is Hound Dog by Elvis Presley. So I am going to play the video on one side of my screen over here, and then I'm going to kind of circle each time we start a new theme. I'm going to be talking through most of it, just making sure you understand. You ain't nothing but a We're going to start off right away with the A theme. Here's the next A theme. So in the second A theme, the music is exactly the same, but the words have changed. You might have also noticed that these lines are in phrases. So this whole, these two lines are one phrase. This is the second phrase, and this is the third phrase. Yeah, they said you was high class. Back to the A theme. So an interlude is going to be where the voice is not singing the melody. For our purposes in this class, we're not going to be identifying the part of the theme that the interlude is. So anytime you hear instruments only, you're just going to write interlude. So that was Hound Dog by Elvis Presley. So in review, strophic form is one melodic theme repeated through the song. It's very common in songs with verses. It could also be called AAA form. Repeats of phrases are allowed within the same melody. So we heard an example of that in Hound Dog because it was, "You ain't nothing but a hound dog, crying all the time." And then we hear exactly the same thing. "You ain't nothing but a hound dog, crying all the time." So that was a repeated phrase inside of the same melody or theme. It's not a very common instrumental form. There is one type of song called a theme and variations form that you instrumentalists will use that is considered strophic. But it is a very common vocal form. So examples of strophic songs are going to be hymns that don't have a refrain or chorus, and folk tunes. For example, "O Susanna" is a folk tune that is strophic. And then some other pop songs, we have "Bridge Over Troubled Water" by Simon and Garfunkel. And that takes care of our strophic video for today. So in the discussion for today, you need to think about your childhood. Think about a childhood song that you know that would be strophic. So the same melody, but with different words. Have a great one.